guys, welcome back to another episode of Grave Reviews. My name is Chris, and today I've checked out the new horror movie, Reed's Point. A movie about New Jersey Devil. That's right. The New Jersey Devil, which is not a euphemism. It's not a sexual act. I mean, it probably is a sexual act, too, because there's degenerates in New Jersey. My God, man. My God. Anyways, I digress about sexual acts. We can dive into that later. But for now, I need to talk about Reed's Point, which is a movie directed by Dale Fabrigar. So the movie follows these two teens who are returning to Reed's Point, where a year earlier they were in a RV crash and their friend was pulled away from the crash. And they're the only two survivors. But during the crash, they feel like they've seen something. Perhaps the New Jersey Devil. Or, no, it's just, that's what they thought they saw. I don't know why I said or. But when they return, things are not as they seem, and some hijinks ensue in Reed's Point. So, not the biggest fan of Reed's Point, not gonna lie. A pretty disappointing movie in quite a few ways. The first 10 minutes of this movie are rough, and the acting is very bad. The writing, maybe worse. Ugh. And then you get some ridiculous just amateur filmmaking stuff. And I get it. They're trying to crash an RV in the opening of the movie. And you're like, well, I'm not actually going to crash an RV. So how do we sell this? And I'm not quite sure that worked. I feel like there could have been cleverer ways in doing so on a budget. But maybe I'm wrong. I mean, everybody going, we're getting in a fucking it's like a fucking episode of Star Trek. But the thing with Star Trek is that you all like the characters and the writing was pretty good. So you were like, I don't care if they're hopping around in their spaceship. I'll buy into it because I'm invested. In this movie, you're like, I don't even understand this setup. It starts with this teens getting on this RV by their uncle who's rich and has like servants on an RV. It's not like it's like a private jet. It's like a fucking RV. Like, is that what rich people are riding around in RVs? I thought like RVs for like middle-income people who like retired and like, I want to drive across America. That's who buys RVs. I don't know anything about RVs. I don't know. So right away, I was like, I don't understand this premise. But then they got into this car accident and the movie kind of shocked me because there is a practical gore effect with ripping an arm off within the first 10 minutes that was shockingly good. It was surprising because the rest of the movie was felt very amateurish. And then to have that visual shown of like competency come through, I was like, unexpected. So this was just a mess. Okay, so let's just run through it. Acting is very poor. The writing is very poor. The story boils down to like a weird Scooby-Doo style episode. Like at one point, I think one of the villains says, and I would have got away with it too if it wasn't for you meddling kids. There is a monster in the movie. The suit looks okay. But the movie's not shot particularly well, lit very well to like hide any of the flaws of it. And the thing of this is like, there's not that many New Jersey Devil movies that I'm aware of. And I don't really know anything about the New Jersey Devil like legend. So they could have taken the time to like explain some of the lore of the New Jersey Devil, but they don't. Instead, they craft this weird story with a ton of melodrama about these teens and this RV incident and coming back and blah, 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 the town is involved, and land, and blah, it's just like, no. No! Not like this. Not like this, guys.
What do they call them? Millennials?
Come on, Eric.
Gen Zers?
Something like that. Ooh, millennials.
So you get a little bit of horror elements the first 10 minutes of the movie, like, for like 30 seconds of those 10 minutes. But around 50 minutes in, maybe a little earlier than that, I wrote down, there's no monster, there's no horror. Finally, the end, it ramps back up with some horror elements, but for the most part, not much is happening in the middle section of the movie. They're going on hikes, falling down hills, stuff like that. It feels like filler, it feels uninteresting. This was a dull, boring movie. Nothing that really sticks out here, except for a few instances of gory kill sequences, which are done decently. So, would I recommend Reed's Point? No, I would not, dear God. I would give Reed's Point a 3 out of 10. This is a pass. Not a very great movie, but if any of this sounds interesting to you, if you're from New Jersey, you're probably used to garbage anyways, so you might as well watch this. Hi-yo! It's just a little joke. I'm from Pennsylvania. Jersey's our neighbor. I don't know what any of that means. Guys, that's it for Reed's Point. If you've seen it, let me know what you think. Otherwise, leave me some recommendations. I'll catch you here next time, guys. Goodbye. Driving that fucking RV. Never drove on an RV. Just you in the open road, driving down the streets at night. That's the life. Eating fucking KFC. That's the life. America. America.